Hi everyone, welcome back to my YouTube videos. In this video, we are going to continue the analysis of the logistic growth process that we started in the previous video. So I briefly remind you that to define the logistic growth process, you start with a set of capital N sites. Those sites can be empty or occupied by one individual. Exactly like in the simple birth and death process, individuals give birth at rate beta and die at rate one. But contrary to the simple birth and death process, the offspring is now sent to a site chosen uniformly at random among this set of N sites. And this offspring can only take place in the system if and only if the target site is empty, which models competition for space. In the previous video, we were able to prove that the infinitesimal variation of the logistic growth process were exactly equal for a specific choice of the intrinsic rate of growth R and carrying capacity K to this logistic equation at the bottom of the slide, which suggest that realizations of the logistic growth process should look like this. However, we also did some simple analysis of the communication classes of the process and whether they are recurrent and transient. And we were able to also prove that eventually we must have extinction of the process. In fact, what happens is that at least when beta is strictly larger than one, and we start, let's say, with one individual, there is a positive probability that the population is going to take off, in which case the process is going to not survive forever, but survive for a very long time. The time it takes until we have extinction is going to be studied in the next video. In this video, what we are going to do is try to describe the behavior of the logistic growth process conditional on survival for this very long time, and try to basically describe those kind of random fluctuation around the carrying capacity that we see in those pictures. So for that, what we are going to do is study a new object that we call the quasi-stationary distribution of the logistic growth process. And by definition, this quasi-stationary distribution, which is going to describe the behavior of the process for a very long time before extinction, is in fact the stationary distribution of a new stochastic process that we call here YT. That's exactly the logistic growth process, but obtained from the logistic growth process by removing zero from the state space, to make sure that there cannot be any extinction. And so in this video, we are going to start by proving this theorem that gives you an explicit expression of the stationary distribution of this new stochastic process YT. So I rewrote the expression here that we want to prove. But before proving that, I'm going to briefly justify that this process YT that we just defined indeed has a unique stationary distribution. So for that, I remind you that in the logistic growth process, you have n plus one state going from state one, from state zero to state n. We saw that zero was an absorbing state, so from zero you can go nowhere, but from one you can go to zero, and from any state you can jump to the previous or the next state. So that means that the directed graph representation of the logistic growth process looks like that. You see that from this picture here that again, zero is alone a communication class that is recurrent, and all those states form a transient class. Now, to obtain the process, YT, we said that we assume that delta one is equal to zero, meaning that if you have only one individual in the system, this individual is not allowed to die. You basically remove this arrow, and so from that you end up with a stochastic process whose directed graph looks like that. The new state space is 1, 2, up to n, and you see from this picture that any state communicates with any other state. So that means that the process YT is finite and irreducible, meaning positive recurrent also and irreducible. And so there is indeed a unique stationary distortion. So that shows existence and uniqueness of the stationary distortion of the process YT. So now, how can we prove that this stationary distortion satisfies this equation? So for that, I'm going to use a result that we saw before about general birth and death processes. We saw that if you have a birth and death process, then in case the stationary distortion exists and is unique, it's characterized by the following equation. So pi x equals beta 0, beta 1, and so on up to beta x minus 1, divided by delta 1, delta 2, and so on up to delta x times pi 0. So that's a result that I proved in a previous playlist about birth and death processes. Now you see that in this expression, the problem is that we use pi 0. In this case, pi 0 doesn't make any sense because 0 is not even in the state space. We removed it from the state space. So what we should do is, in fact, replace this pi 0 by a pi 1. So, and then that means also that we should relabel all those birth and death parameters, and we should remove this one and this one. Okay, so the result we saw about general birth and death process was for birth and death process where zero was in the state space. Now we remove zero from the state space, but the same result remains true, except that now we start at one instead of zero. So this is pi one instead of pi zero. Here we start from beta one, and here we start from delta two instead of beta zero and delta one. So now, the last step is simply to replace those birth and death parameters by their values. That's exactly the same values for the process YT and the process XT, which is the original logistic growth process. So we are just going to replace those expressions by what they are, and we should get this expression here. So that we have a simplification, I'm going to, in fact, extract this term delta x from the denominator here, then I'm going to have a beta x minus 1 divided by delta x minus 1, like things with the same index. I'm going to keep, in fact, so that we have some analog to the beta 1, I'm going to keep, in fact, the delta 1, but have in mind that this delta 1 is in fact equal to 1. If I multiply this expression by 1, I don't change it. And so this delta 1 is in fact the delta 1 for the logistic growth process. The delta 1 that is equal to 1, not the delta 1 for the new process YT, where delta 1 is equal to 0. Okay, so I'm going to do this. And so eventually, what you obtain is that this pi x is going to be equal to pi 1 here divided by delta x. So pi 1 divided by delta x. And then here what's left is the product for z equals 1 to x minus 1 of beta z divided by delta z. You see that delta x is equal to x, so we get indeed this pi 1 over x here to start. So pi 1 divided by x, and then we have the product for z equals 1 to x minus 1 of, so beta z is exactly equal to beta times z times fraction of empty site, 1 minus z over n. So here we have a beta z times 1 minus z over n divided by delta z is equal to z. Eventually you see that we have this simplification the Z here killed each other, then you see that you have a product of terms where you always have a beta. I can extract from that all the betas that gives me a beta to the power x minus 1. That's exactly what we want here. What I'm going to do also is extract some n at the power x minus 1, but then because I have x minus 1 terms here, to compensate, I just multiply each of those terms by n, which gives me n times 1 minus z over n, that's exactly n minus z, okay? And so eventually, we obtain, I'm going to go back to black, so it's equal to pi 1, divided by x times, so we said beta divided by n at the power x minus 1. What's left is exactly the product for z equals 1 to x minus 1 of n minus z. So now if you look at this expression, that's exactly n minus 1 times n minus 2 up to n minus x plus 1. You can rewrite this in increasing order. So that's n minus x plus 1 times n minus x plus 2 and so on up to n minus 1. And so if you expand this and simplify, you exactly obtain this fraction here. If you look at this fraction, that's going to be exactly this n minus 1 factorial, so it's n minus 1 times n minus 2 times n minus 3 up to n minus x plus 1. I stop at a minus x plus 1 because I divide by this after, so I only keep the first terms, and so indeed this product here is equal to this fraction, and so that completes the proof of this theorem. So now to conclude this video, we are going to deduce from this result the fact that the states that are the most visited for this process YT are the states that are close to the carrying capacity. So I remind you from the previous video that what we mean by carrying capacity for the logistic growth process is exactly n times 1 minus 1 over beta, and this result will tell you that indeed the logistic growth process has a behavior that is similar to the logistic equation, in the sense that the states that are the most visited under the quasi-stationary distribution are close to the fixed point of the logistic equation. So to prove this result, instead of using the theorem itself, what we are going to use is this expression of the stationary distribution here. And so first let's look at what this stationary distribution should look like, at least qualitatively. So we go from 1 to n, that's the state space, and here I'm going to kind of draw, at least again qualitatively, some curve that would describe this stationary distribution pi x. So first, I quickly remind you that the birth parameters are equal to beta times x times 1 minus x over n, and the death parameters are equal to delta x equals x. So if again we assume I didn't precise, but all along here we assume that beta is strictly larger than 1. So if beta is strictly larger than 1 and x is very small, we also have in mind that n is pretty large. So if x is small, then this x over n is small. This expression is close to 1, and the beta x is close to beta times x, meaning that at least when the number of individuals is close, is small, because the fraction of empty space is close to 1, most of the births are going to be successful, which means that the process is going to initially, when the number of individuals is small, behave like the birth and death process. And so here, if you look at the ratio of birth rate divided by death rate, if you forget about this term, when x is small, you have something strictly larger than 1. So birth rate is larger than death rate, and so that means that the process tends to increase when the number of individuals is small. At the opposite, when the number of individuals is close to n, you see that this x over n is going to be close to 1, this is close to 0, and so eventually the ratio is going to be something that is much less than 1, and so meaning that when you have kind of saturation of the space and most of the space is occupied, then birth rate is much smaller than death rate, and so that means that in average, at least, the number of individuals is going to decrease, and so you get this picture here. And so because of that, we expect that at least under this stationary distribution or quasi-stationary distribution of the logistic growth process, the state that are small close to one should not be visited often, the one close to n should not be visited often, and we expect some kind of monotonicity with like basically this stationary distribution being represented by something that looks like this. Okay, and so now the question is, what is, you know, this value here? Okay, and what we want to prove is that the maximum here is reached at the carrying capacity. So for that, you see that one way to characterize those states here that are close to that are the most visited is to say that that's kind of the state at which pi x plus 1 divided by pi x should be close to 1. Okay, so that means that eventually here, if you compare states in this neighborhood, instead of having a big increase or a big decrease, then you should be at about the same value. So to find the values of, you know, the states that are the most visited, what we are going to do is find all the x such that pi x plus 1 divided by pi x is equal to 1. So I'm going to write that. We have this in mind again. This picture was to explain the motivation of the proof. Now what we want to do is argue that, I mean, use the fact that the most visited states let's say x must satisfy this equation here, so pi x plus 1 divided by pi x equals 1. Okay, so we want to find x such that this is true. We could use this expression, but that's going to be a little bit complicated. Instead, it's in fact a little bit simpler to go back to this expression, and you see that here from the expression of pi x, clearly pi x plus 1 is exactly equal to pi x times beta x divided by delta x plus 1, so that means that this ratio here, in fact, is equal to beta x divided by delta x plus 1. You see that if you replace both by their values, that's going to be equal to beta x divided by this x plus 1 times 1 minus x over n. And so what we want to solve eventually is this equals to 1. You see that also, because we assume n large, I'm going to do a little simplification and say that this is roughly like this beta x divided by x plus 1 is about equal to beta. Okay, and so I'm going to use this approximation here. This is about equal to beta times 1 minus x over n. And so the last step is just to solve this equals to 1, and we'll see which value of x this gives. And so for that, let me go back here. So solving this equation, so beta x beta times 1 minus x over n equals 1, we get that 1 minus x over n is equal to 1 over beta, which also gives you that x over n is equal to 1 minus 1 over beta, which also gives you that x is equal to n times 1 minus 1 over beta. And that's indeed the current capacity. That's at least the way we define the current capacity K in the previous video. And so indeed, in conclusion, we were able to prove that, like at the bottom of the slide, under this quasi-stationary distribution, the most visited states are the ones that are close to the current capacity, which corresponds to the fixed point of the logistic equation.